Tonight, Catholic Extension returns to King Street, where 35 years ago, the very first recipient of the Lumen Christi Award, Florence Castor, who is still living, was honored. And on this 35th anniversary, we return to honor these three women religious, the Felician Sisters of Kingstree, South Carolina. And we are here to proclaim loudly and clearly that we have come to recognize the light of Christ in your lives and in your wonderful ministry.
We have a lot of programs, we do a lot of things, but the most important ministry we have brought to Kingstree and Williamsburg County is the ministry of our presence. We made it a pact when we first moved here that that would be our main ministry, that we will be present to people, we will be present to the neighbors, we will be present to the church, we will be there, we will be in those circles of people where we needed to be.
About 2 years ago, I went up to visit the Felician Sisters and their ministry in Kingstree, and I was wonderfully impressed by the tremendous sense of joy that the sisters exhibited in the ministry that they were participating in. I was really impressed by the whole operation, the food pantry, the tutoring of the children, the door-to-door visitation, the ecumenical outreach, just so much. And when I looked at that and I said, you know, this is really an effective way for the church to live the gospel in one of the poorest areas of our diocese.
When I first remember sisters coming here, my first thoughts was, wow, they're going on Thorne Avenue. This is the roughest place in Williamsburg County and King Street. I thought it was crazy.
We're Franciscan sisters. And so we have that mandate of our Father Francis of go repair my house. And so, you know, go repair my house doesn't mean from the old church to the synagogue or the new building that we put up, but the house of the people of God. Go repair, you know, misconceptions. Go repair prejudices.
The sisters have crossed the two barriers, the racial and religious barriers. They united all of them. It's incredible, absolutely incredible. If you knew what it was like before then.
There's a certain sense of fulfillment that I have experienced in knowing that, you know, we are assisting these people. You know, we are assisting with feeding the poor and, you know, helping the oppressed. It is a very rewarding experience being here in Kingstree.
Well, like my cousin next door, she was saying that it makes the community feel safer now, you know, because we had a lot of stuff going on around here, break-ins down the street and stuff, but it's much safer, you know. A lot of people have a lot of respect for them.
Our ministry, when we first came here, we thought would be to the people of Thorne Avenue, the people around us. And as the years went on, we realized that there's more to this than just, you know, what we were doing.
That's the almost unbelievable thing in the rural South, to see the cooperation rather than the competition between churches, and to see old biases and worries pushed aside to do the work of God and be the light of Christ in the world. That's the thing that really and truly is amazing and a blessing to us all, to learn something really about Christianity, to be able to work together.
Until then, only the Catholic Church, as small as it is, served the Blessed Angela meal. And they did it once a month, and they were the only people. Other churches started getting involved. Today, we have 11 different churches in the community who serve a Blessed Angela meal once a month.
Everybody loves the sisters, everybody. I could name just about every church in this community that is involved with the sisters in one way or the other. And you've got volunteers from, you know, every walk of the community, every church.
A lot of kids from the community get involved, and they keep a lot of them off the streets. It always something to do. Homework program is great. So, I love it. I hope they never leave.
We've had a couple from our little town here in the homework program, where we were working with them coming up. see a couple of them have gone through and actually have graduated from college. Now, you know, that's great to see a product of your establishment going that far.
They have kind of cleaned up the neighborhood. Like I said before, you know, they inspire me to keep up my yard and keep up my house and carry myself in a certain way because I take pride in our community, and I think it trickled down starting from now.
We said, we will fall in love with the people, and the people will call forth from us what they need. But the needs were not just of Kingstree or the needs of Williamsburg County. They were the needs of our sisters who wanted to feed the hungry and to clothe the naked and to visit the sick and to give drink to the thirsty and to be light for this part of God's world with all of you.
We've been very conscious of the gift of three women who walked into your life and simply said, I am for you. Who followed a wonderful example in a woman, Blessed Angela, who said, just go, be present to others, be life-giving, be a force of life and love into the world, especially with the poor,